Hola a todos y bienvenidos. Hi everybody and welcome to our fourth Spanish lesson. So today we are going to be focusing on los números. What do you think los números could be? We have briefly touched on los números before in school. So los números are numbers and we're going to be learning numbers uno, one, through to diez, 10. But before we do that, I'm going to very quickly revise with you the names of some shapes, because in today's lesson, we're going to be using los números, the numbers, with things that we have already learnt to talk about how many in a group. So we're going to be using it with los animales, animals, las formas, shapes, and los colores and colors. Okay, so just before we start, let's very quickly refresh our memories about shapes. Okay. El círculo. Remember? El círculo, a circle. El cuadrado. Remember, four corners, cuadrado. Think of a quad bike as having four wheels. Cuadrado, four corners. Cuadrado, a square. La estrella. La estrella, a star. El rectángulo. El rectángulo, a rectangle. And finally, el triángulo, a triangle. Okay, so I'm going to share my screen with you now, and we're going to look at what our learning is going to be today. So we've just revised our shapes. Okay, if you're watching the live lessons, then we'll be typing our answers in the comments. Okay, if you're watching from home and you're watching pre-recorded, then obviously we've just had to go at revising our shapes already. So before we start, though, I'd like to show you my Salon de la Fama, my Hall of Fame. And my Hall of Fame is showing all the lovely work that I've had in this week from children working either in school or from home. Okay, so I'm just waiting for it to load up now. So there we go. So you can see we've had some children sending back some work with their shapes, and we've had some children sending back work about their MFL project. And this week we looked at Finland, or last week I should say, we looked at Finland. This week we are looking at China. So it'd be really great to see your work coming in, to see if you can get featured in my Salon de la Fama. And remember, if your work is sent back in to me, I will give you a raffle ticket, and next week we're going to draw the prize, and it's called El Gordo. It's a big one. Okay, and you'll receive a prize. So to get your name on a raffle ticket, though, remember, you have to send back your purple creation task or your MFL project or both. Okay, so well done to those children. Muy bien. Very good work. So what we're learning to do today, then, what is our LFPA? So we are learning to count to 10 in Spanish. And the focus of this, then, is to be able to recognize the words from 1 to 10. So recognizing our numbers 1 to 10. The purpose of this, then, is to identify quantity, so an amount within a group. And the assessment, then, by the end of the lesson, you should be able to recognise, say, and understand numbers from 1 to 10. If you look at the bottom, it says there is a Google form to be completed. Okay, so I'm going to send this Google form out to you. Send it back to me. Have a go. Try your best. Don't worry if you don't get all the answers right. It's multiple choice anyway, so you've got a choice of four answers. So one of them is going to be right. So you've got a 25% chance anyway of getting it right, even if you have a guess. Okay, but send it back in to me and you will get a raffle ticket as well. So let's have a revision then. I'm going to show you a video and it's talking about or singing about shapes. I want to know what is the word for heart, okay? If you're watching this live, be typing your answer in the comments. If you're listening to this pre-recorded at home, obviously you can just say out loud as soon as you spot it.
Hola, vamos a aprender juntos las formas. ¿Estás listo? Vamos a empezar. Cuadrado. Círculo. Triángulo. Rectángulo. Cuadrado, círculo. cuadrado. Círculo. Triángulo. Rectángulo. Cuadrado, círculo, triángulo, rectángulo. Estrella.
Listen carefully.
Estrella, corazón, óvalo, rombo, estrella, corazón, óvalo, rombo. Estrella, corazón, óvalo, rombo.
Okay, so did you find the word for heart? It was corazón. Muy bien. Okay, so what we're going to do now, I'm going to go over the words for the numbers uno, one, two, diez, ten, one to ten with you. Okay, so escuchad y repetid. So I want you to copy me. Uno. You try it. Uno. Uno. Uno is one. Dos. Dos. You try it. Dos. Tres. Uno, dos, tres. Three. Tres. Can you remember three starts with the same letter as in English with a T? Tres. Very similar to cuadrado for four. Cuatro. Can you hear we've got that qua sound at the start of the word again? Cuatro. Cuatro. Show me cuatro fingers. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro. Cuatro, four. Cinco, five. Cinco. Okay, cinco. Because it sounds very similar to think in English. Cinco. And remember, in Spanish, we say the C with a th sound, cinco. But if you were in South America, you would say cinco. Okay, so you can hear it two different ways. Cinco. Or cinco. But because we're learning Spanish as in the country of Spain, we're going to say cinco. Okay? So that's just to make you aware of the difference. Seis. Again, just like in English, it starts with the same letter, S. Seis. Six. Seis. Siete. Again, like number seven, it starts with an S. Siete. So if we think of six is one syllable, seis, six, seis. Seven, two syllables, seven. In Spanish, three syllables, siete. You try it, siete, siete. And siete is number seven. Show me siete fingers. So we've got cinco, there's five, and we need two more, dos más. Seis, siete, siete, ocho, ocho. And I always remember ocho as being number eight, starts with an O, and it makes me think of octopus or octagon, all of these things that have eight legs, eight sides. So you know the word octo means eight. So ocho sounds quite similar. So all the time when we're learning a language, we're trying to make those links to help us to forge sort of pathways between words to help us to remember them better. Okay? Ocho. Nueve. Nueve. You say it. Nueve. Nueve is number nine. And finalmente, diez. Diez. You say it. Diez. Okay, let's try together then. Uno. Dos. Tres. Cuatro. Cinco. You try it. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco. Remember, cinco. Thinking of it. Cinco, number five. Seis. Siete. Six and seven. Seis, siete. Ocho. Think of an octopus, eight legs. Ocho. Nueve. Diez. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis. Siete, ocho, nueve, diez. Okay? So, what we're going to do now, I'm going to share my screen with you and we are going to listen to a song and then I'm going to ask you a couple of questions about it, okay? So, with this song, I want you to listen carefully because you're going to hear all of the numbers in a quite a catchy little tune, okay? And then I want you to think about what other colours are mentioned in the song. Okay, are you ready? Join in with the singing if you can. Okay, so hopefully then you heard some other colours in the song and you also kind of remember the words for 1 to 10 because it's quite a catchy tune, isn't it? Okay, so it helps you to remember the numbers in the correct order. So what other colours were mentioned in the song then? We had rosa for pink, we had blanco for white, we had marron for brown, we had negro for black, gris for grey, and morado for purple. Okay, so well done if you picked those out. Okay, so now what I'm going to ask you is ¿cuántas tortugas? Okay, so you need to tell me in Spanish the number of tortoises that you can see. So we're going to count them. Let's try the first one together. Are you ready? We'll count together. Uno, dos, tres. ¿Cuántas tortugas? How many tortugas are there? There are tres tortugas. Hay tres tortugas. Let's try the next one. Okay, so you're going to count. ¿Cuántos gatos? How many cats are there? Okay, so remember, if you're watching this from home, you can pause it while you work out the answer. Okay, so if you want to hit pause while you work it out, and we'll go through it together then. Okay, perfecto. Let's count together. ¿Cuántos gatos? How many cats are there? I can see uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis. Hay seis gatos. There are six cats. ¿Cuántas serpientes? How many snakes are there? Okay, again, pause it while you work it out. And let's go through the answer. So, ¿cuántas serpientes? How many snakes? I can see. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis, siete, ocho, nueve, diez. Diez. Hay diez serpientes. There are 10 snakes. ¿Cuántos conejos? How many rabbits are there? So pause it while you count. And let's go through the answers together. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro. Cuatro. Hay cuatro conejos. There are four rabbits. ¿Cuántos cuadrados verdes? What does that mean? What am I asking you to do? ¿Cuántos cuadrados verdes? Perfecto. How many green squares? Let's count them together. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco. Hay cinco cuadrados verdes. There are five green squares. Now remember, in Spanish, the adjective, the describing word, goes after the noun in most cases. So here we have hay cinco cuadrados verdes. The color goes at the end of my sentence. ¿Cuántas estrellas? How many stars? Let's count. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis, siete. Hay siete estrellas. There are seven stars. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to call out a number. You need to quickly touch the group with that number of mice in it. Okay? So I want you to splat. El grupo de cuatro. So quickly touch the group that has cuatro ratones. Four mice. Muy bien. Okay, can you splat el grupo de seis? El grupo de seis. Okay, so you should be looking at the group with uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis. Seis ratones, six mice. Can you quickly splat el grupo de cinco? Remember, cinco, we have uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, five. Muy bien, very good. Now, can you splat el grupo de nueve? El grupo de nueve. So you're looking for the group of nueve. What number was nueve? Nine, perfecto. And can you count how many triángulos, how many triangles are in the other group? Ocho. Ocho. Muy bien. So now then, our thinking task, our second thinking task, is I want you to tell me what is my number. Now again, you can pause this while you work out your answers, okay? I want you to feel that when the lessons are moving, they're not moving too fast. So if you need to pause things while you're working it out, that's absolutely fine, okay? So have a look where it says, what is my number? Underneath, we've got the word más, which means add or more, menos, which means subtract or less. So the first question is asking you, what is tres más que dos? What is three more than two? So, have two, And I need to add three more. Uno, dos, tres. Three more than two is five. So I want to know, what is cinco más que tres? Cinco más que tres. So I need to know, what is five more than three? So I need to find three first. Uno, dos, tres. And I need to find cinco más, five more. So uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco. What is five more than three? And my answer is ocho. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis, siete, ocho. Eight. Okay? So you need to work your way through these questions. Number three, uno más que nueve. What is uno más que nueve? So, first of all, let's count nueve. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis, siete, ocho, nueve. Let's put that one down. So, nueve is nine. Uno más, one more, diez. Number four, numero cuatro. Cuatro más que cuatro. So first of all, we need to find cuatro. Count them on your fingers. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro. And now we need cuatro más. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro. How many altogether? Count them. Ocho. Muy bien. Okay. Número cinco, number five. Diez menos seis. Now remember, menos means subtract or take away or less than. So diez menos seis. So let's start with diez. Menos seis. Let's take away seis. Are you ready? Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis. What do I have? ¿Qué número es? What number is it? Uno, dos, tres, cuatro. Muy bien. And finalmente, the last question, número seis. Ocho menos siete. So first of all, we need to find ocho. So let's count together. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis, siete, ocho. Menos siete. How many am I taking away? What does siete mean? Let's take away siete. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis, siete. And my answer is uno. Muy bien. Okay, look at the four cuadrados. Look at my four squares. Each box is incorrect. Okay, so there's something wrong in every single box that you can see. But why? What's wrong with it? Let's have a look at numero uno first. Numero uno, number one, it says, hay dos círculos rojos. Why is that not right? Muy bien. It's incorrect because there's actually tres círculos. My sentence says, hay dos círculos. But that's wrong because we can see tres círculos. There are three circles, not two. Let's look at number two, numero dos. It says, hay diez rectángulos verdes. Let's have a count. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis, siete, ocho, nueve, diez. Well, I can see 10, so it can't be the number. Hay diez rectángulos verdes. What does it mean? There are 10 what? Rectangles, 10 green rectangles. So why is this not correct? Perfecto, because they are triangulos, they are triangles, not rectangles. Okay, let's have a look at numero tres. Number three, it says, hay seis cuadrados azules. So let's check the number. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco. There are cinco cuadrados azules. But my sentence says, hay seis cuadrados azules. So why is it wrong? The sentence means that there are six blue squares, but we can see that there are actually only cinco, there are only five. And número cuatro, it says, hay ocho estrellas verdes. Let's count. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis, siete, ocho. We've got the correct number, so what else could be wrong? Hay ocho estrellas verdes. What's wrong? El color, it's the color. It says, hay ocho estrellas verdes, which means there are eight green stars. We know they're not green. What color are they? How do we say color in Spanish? Naranja. Hay ocho estrellas naranjas. Muy bien. Okay, then your explaining task. I want you to explain how we can tell that there is more than one of each shape in the boxes below without seeing a picture or a number. So, escuchad, listen carefully. En la caja, so in the box, hay cuadrados. Have a look at the larger box. En la caja, hay estrellas. How do we know that there's more than one of these shapes in the box without seeing a picture and without a number? What clue can you see from what is written on the box? Muy bien, really good thinking if you have spotted the S suffix on the end of the name of the shape. So if we had one square, it would be un cuadrado. But if we have more than one, we have to show that. We have to make the word for square plural. So we have to add the S suffix, like we do in English. Okay, one square, two squares. So hay dos cuadrados. So en la caja hay estrellas. How many estrellas? Let's say there's cinco. Let's say there's five. So en la caja hay cinco estrellas. Okay, so one star is una estrella. More than one, for instance, five. Cinco estrellas. Okay, so you should be able to hear the s sound at the end of the word, which shows that there is more than one. It is plural. Okay, so explain which words have changed and why. So we've got pictures now and we've got numbers. So it says, en la caja hay un triángulo rojo. And in the second box, it says, en la caja hay tres triángulos rojos. Which words have changed and why? So pause it while you have a think. Muy bien, very good. So you will see then in the first box, hay un triángulo rojo. There is a red triangle. In the second box, you'll see hay tres triángulos rojos. So if you look, the word for triangle, triángulo, has got the S suffix. And the word for red, rojo, also has the S suffix. And that's because in Spanish, nouns have to agree with the adjectives in gender, whether they are masculine or feminine, but also in number. So if there is more than one of an object, the noun has an S suffix, but you also need to make the colour plural too. So it has to, what we call, agree. Okay, so your purple creation task this week then, I thought it would be really nice if you could do a bit of a scavenger hunt. Okay, so you can pause this while you work out what it is you need to get. So it says, take a photo and send it in once you have collected all of the items on my list. So I'm looking for tres books, seis spoons, ocho socks, uno key, cinco tins of food, cuatro DVDs or games or CDs or something to that kind of look, dos toothbrushes, and siete pens or pencils. Okay, so you need to work out what the numbers are and find that amount of the object, put it all together and take a photograph and send it in. So remember, tres books, seis spoons, ocho socks. Uno key. Cinco tins of food. Cuatro DVDs or CDs or computer games. Dos toothbrushes. And siete pens or pencils. So once you've gathered all of these items together, take a photograph and send it in. And remember, you'll get a raffle ticket for any work you submit. If you really want to challenge yourself, okay, this is quite a tricky task. So this is for those of you that think, yeah, I want to push my limits and go a little bit further with my Spanish today. Can you complete and design a Sudoku puzzle? Okay, so if you have a look at the pictures, it shows you what Sudoku is. But instead of writing the digits, so that's the numerals in the boxes, I'd like you to write the Spanish word for that number. So, for instance, where you would have the number two, you'd have to write dos, okay? So remember, every line vertically, so that's going from top to bottom, and every line horizontally going across, has to have the numbers 1 through to 9 in each, okay? But also, each square has to have each number only once, okay? So this is a super tricky one. Okay, so can you design and complete a Sudoku puzzle, but instead of writing the digits in the box, write the Spanish word for that number. Remember, every line vertically and horizontally has to have the numbers 1 to 9, but also every box has to have the numbers 1 to 9 in it. Okay, you can't have the same number in the box. You can't have the same number more than once in the line either way. Okay, so I told you it was super tricky. Okay, so the last thing then, if you get time, and I would really like you to have a go at this because it helps me to see what you've understood and what you need a bit more help with. There is a Google form to be completed, okay? So your teachers will send out the link for you. There are raffle tickets to everyone who submits their answers back to me, okay? As I said before, don't worry if you don't know the answers. They are all multiple choice, so you've got a 25% chance of getting it right anyway because there are 4 options to choose from. So just try your best, have a go, but do read each option carefully, okay? So have a go at that. I'd love to see your work. So if you do have a go at the scavenger hunt, please send in the photos. If you are feeling really motivated and want to really push your limits and show you're remarkable, have a go at the Sudoku because I'd be really interested to see what you've come up with. And please, if you don't do either of those, please do have a go at the Google form for me because it shows me what I need to do as your teacher to help you to learn more Spanish. Okay, so thank you very much. Muchas gracias for taking the time to join us in our lesson. Okay, have a go at the tasks and I will speak to you next week where we'll be drawing our raffle. So make sure you get your tickets in by completing the work and sending it in. Okay, muchas gracias. Hasta luego.